636 at News Talk 1440 WROK. Riley and Scott, Friday morning. Thanks for waking up with us. Clear skies, 18 degrees is what you're getting first, and it feels like it's 8 with the wind. Candace will tell you about that coming up. Also, Dave's going to run down some sports for you. But in the meanwhile, let's head over to the phone, spend some time with Emily Kahn from Roll Call. She's got some clues here for us about potential Democratic Senate candidates right here in the land of Lincoln. Emily, good morning.
Good morning to you.
How you doing this morning?
Oh, well, it's cold here, too, so I'm not looking forward to the cold weather.
No. Turn the heat up. If need be, you can go back in the house during the interview. We don't want you to be cold.
Peace out. I believe last Friday, Democrats fear primary mess in Illinois Senate race, Emily, at rollcall.com. Mark Kirk is up for re-election in 2016. Thought to be vulnerable because Illinois is blue, or at least a purple state. Bruce Rauner, a Republican, not a governor. But anyway, point being, there will be Democrats lining up to take on Mark Kirk. The first question, of course, is will Mark Kirk run? And for a while there, you couldn't stumble around without hitting someone else who had asked Mark Kirk, are you going to run? He has been giving unequivocal yeses to those questions. He will run in 2016. Nothing you've heard to the contrary, correct?
Yeah, I mean, up on Capitol Hill, people ask him. He sat down with us shortly after the November election, and his exact phrasing to me was, no frickin' way am I retiring. So I think it's been pretty clear.
I hate it when guys tap dance around, won't give me a straight answer to something.
So, he definitely will.
He's come a long way back from what he was dealing with the stroke. The rehabilitation has been outstanding. Apparently, logging lots and lots of hours. Very optimistic about his chances of retaining that seat. So, in addition to him telling you no freaking way, and basically the same thing to us, I don't see anything, and we don't really either. That's going to jump up and make him say, you know, no, I changed my mind.
No, and, you know, I think Republicans will circle the wagons around him. I think they think he's the best Republican to win, or, you know, the only one who could win statewide in Illinois in that race. So I think they're going to do everything they can to support him.
Emily Kahn with us from Roll Call, her piece on Democrats who are interested in Mark Kirk's U.S. Senate seat. So now we begin to look. At least four Democrats have said they're interested, and those are just the Congress people, congressmen and congresswomen. You might have Lisa Madigan or someone statewide say the same thing. But the four who have said, yeah, I'm at least interested, I'm looking at it, include Tammy Duckworth, congresswoman from the Chicago suburbs. She might be the favorite right now, I suppose, and it kind of depends on how things play out. What are you hearing about Tammy Duckworth's interest in this race?
Well, I spoke to her on Martin Luther King Day, actually, and she is very interested. You know, I think Democrats want her to run. They think that her story is one that will match up well against Mark Kirk, you know, a woman who was, her helicopter was shot down while she was serving in Iraq, and she lost her legs and has, you know, damage to her arms. So, you know, in terms of the, you know, potential sympathy vote that maybe people fear Kirk would get, you know, she kind of negates that. And she has, you know, a story to tell that I think Democrats are excited about.
But one of the things with her as well, she's a mom, got a family going on as well, and we got kind of the buzz earlier on, wasn't really sure if that sort of deep commitment is what she was looking to do.
Yeah, you know, we talked about her baby. She's still on maternity leave. She'll be back in Washington and back to work in February. And, you know, she said that, you know, it's hard for her to even leave her baby for 45 minutes to go to the store. She misses her daughter. So, you know, that's something that everyone has to think about. But she said she has a support system that helps her take care of her child. And, you know, she will weigh her bid, you know, based on what's right for her family.
Emily Kahn with us from Roll Call. RollCall.com. Democrats fear primary mess in Illinois Senate race. Congressman Bill Foster from the southwest suburbs of Chicago also expressing an interest. He was in Congress, was defeated, came back, just won re-election. His edge might be the fundraising, meaning, well, he can do it himself. He's the 51st wealthiest member of Congress.
Yeah, so he has a fundraising edge. You know, he too comes from the Chicago suburbs, which, as everyone knows, is a key voting block in the state. But, you know, and everyone kind of who has been weighing this has a path. in a primary, a lot of this is going to be who can raise the money, and he clearly has, you know, the ability to do that or put in some money himself if he felt like he needed to.
Emily, Congresswoman Sherry Bustos from the 17th District, which encompasses a bunch of our listening audience, is also interested, or at least feeling out a potential run for 2016. She has some deep personal ties with U.S. Senator Dick Durbin, used to babysit his kids, in fact. Is there fear among other Illinois Democrats that if Sherry Bustos gets in, she might have Dick Durbin lining up right behind her?
Yeah, that's the thing that we have not heard about yet. We've asked Durbin on the Hill what he thinks, you know, if he's gotten involved, if he has a favorite, and he declined to say. But, you know, it certainly would be a hard decision for him. He, too, is a supporter of Congresswoman Duckworth. He helped recruit her and was a supporter of her in her bids for office. So it would definitely be a challenge for him if both of them decided they wanted to do it. But what he actually told us was, you know, he thinks Democrats are going to work to make sure that they, you know, don't have kind of a messy bloodbath here in this primary.
Emily Kahn with us from Roll Call, rollcall.com. It's Rodney and Scott on WROK. And the fourth congresswoman, the fourth congressperson to express an interest in the race, the most recent one, is Congresswoman Robin Kelly from the old Jesse Jackson Jr. district on Chicago's south side. What is her path to a potential win?
Well, you know, so say you have Tammy Duckworth running and Bill Foster gets in. You know, Congresswoman Kelly is from the Chicago area. She is an African-American woman, and, you know, there's about 30% of primary voters who are African-American, so she would appeal to that base. And when you have three people in a race, you know, 30% easily could win you a primary. So I think she thinks that is her path. Her biggest challenge would be fundraising. She was never a strong fundraiser. And what won her special election after Jesse Jackson Jr. left was that former New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg's anti-gun PAC came in and spent a lot of money for her. So she would need to step up her fundraising game if she wanted to have a shot at this.
So, Emily, there's at least four with interest. As I mentioned earlier, no one really knows what Lisa Madigan's plans are. She's a very popular attorney general. People thought she was going to run for governor here. She passed to run again for attorney general. Might she have an interest in 2016? We don't really know. So it could be a crowded primary field. You said Dick Durbin thinks that they'll work it out kind of behind the scenes. Do other Democrats share his view, or are they really worried about a very expensive, very contentious race in what would then be a pretty tough general race against Mark Kirk?
Yeah, you know, well, first, I think the fact that this many people are openly considering running shows that Democrats think Mark Kirk is vulnerable. People wouldn't be putting their neck out there and saying they want to run if they thought that this race was not winnable. But at the same time, you know, if everyone thinks they have a pass and everyone jumps in here, it certainly will be, you know, an expensive race to run. Advertising in Chicago is millions of dollars a week. And, of course, that's money that you can't use for a general election, and Mark Kirk will have enough money. And, you know, if he doesn't have a primary, be sitting on millions of his own dollars, aside from, you know, I don't know if you guys saw that the Koch brothers announced that they're going to spend almost $1 billion in this upcoming election, too. So, you know, it could be an issue if they are out there spending millions of dollars in a primary that they can't spend focusing on Kirk.
I would love to be in the position to be a candidate running for something, only to have somebody pop up behind me and go, you know, we got about $1 billion. We're going to start sinking into some races, and we like you, young man. That would,
it's quite a number. It's hard to even fathom what $1 billion looks like. So,
well, viewers in big markets are going to get a chance to see. Emily Kahn from Roll Call, thanks a lot for taking time out of your morning for us.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
We appreciate it. 6:45 at News Talk 1440 WROK.
Who's the bad guy?